Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to get into the Drake sound design, and we're going to take influences from Party Next Door, and we're going to go with that really retro pitch bending sound that he likes to use, mainly because nobody else is doing it. So let's go into Serum. I'm going to use this plugin to demonstrate because it gives you a cool approach to sound. Now right now all we have is a sawtooth with three different octaves playing E. So it's not a chord, it's just an octave. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is think of it individually. So as producers, we love to hit unison and just simply detune it. But I'm gonna think of detuning manually using each oscillator. So let's activate oscillator B, and let's think of it as a way to detune away from oscillator A. What that means is if I change the fine tune of oscillator B from A, plus or minus, it's going to give me a chorusing type of sound. So let me turn the volume down so it doesn't get too crazy. So I'm going to play the pattern here, and I'm going to move the fine tune pitch around, and you're going to hear like a chorusy type of sound. So we're going to modulate that fine-tune pitch, okay, so that it kind of overlaps the pitch of A. Now we're going to do this for each, so they're going to have two different speeds, but we're going to use LFO 1. You can use a triangular shape, or you can, let me see if I can load up the sine wave. I like sine wave because it's a little smoother than a triangle wave. So let's load up the sine wave shape, drag it atop the fine-tune pitch, and lower your range. So that's the key here. You don't want a huge fine-tuned pitch bend. You could, but it gets very obvious at that point. Now what we need to do is take it off BPM speed and lower the rate or the speed. This is very, it sounds almost like a pulse wave. So I might switch this out for a triangle to give us more of a varying tone. Okay, so you can hear it detune slowly over time. Now we're going to do the same thing, but this time I'm going to start lower from the fine-tuned pitch for A. We're going to start at a lower pitch. Let's actually create a new LFO at a completely different speed. So the trick here is to have two different speeds, and let's drag that atop the fine-tuned pitch. And part B has a wide range, so let's lower that range. Let's lower the octave so we can... Okay, so they're at the same octave. Let's lower one lower than the other. I'm going to take out the bass tone. So we only have two octaves of E now. Now we need to make it an impact sound. So by default, envelope one controls the overall amp envelope for the sound. Let's give it a nice decay and a nice release. So we're going to give it a nice 1 second, almost 2 second release time. And we're going to add a filter now. And you can use the same envelope to control your cutoff filter frequency. Now make sure oscillator B is also being sent to the low pass filter. Now I don't want it to start that high, so I'm going to lower the range here so it doesn't start at such a high frequency. Now one needs to go faster, so let's use LFO 1 to make that go faster. Let's crank up the volume. You can add a sublayer to thicken it up if you want to make this a bass element. And you can drag your envelope atop the level. I think it actually follows the amp envelope, the sub sound here. So that's how you create that wobbly type of sound. Now you can try out different waveforms than just that saw. You can do retro saws, different things. Let's switch it out. So we get just a different tone. Let's go analog and let's try a rounded saw. Just for a different kind of impact. Let's open up the filter a bit. Okay, so let's add some effects like delay so it can continue kind of bouncing around. And let's do this on one half. Let's crank up the reverb so it has a nice tail to it. Let me exaggerate some of these pitch ranges so we can hear more of the effect. If you do it too fast and too wide of a range, it sounds too playful. So that's why. If you're going to do a wide range, do a slower speed. Now what I'm doing here is trying to remove this, modulator, because I think I had it in one direction. Let's do that one more time. So now it has an even range. I think it was only going in one direction before. Now another way of thinking about it is you can add unison and then detune those. So it's like detuning an already detuned sound. Try that. So let's play multiple notes so you can get a context of what this would sound like. So let's play some notes to demonstrate how they would use it in like a Party Next Door style track. Now we're going to use really low notes, maybe an octave lower. Notice the presence of that sub bass. Now LFO 2 is going a little too fast. Let's slow that down. I added unison to try and thick up the sound a bit. Thicken up the sound. You can add phaser and chorusing to really blur it out. But it's already pitched. It's already chorusy, so you really don't need chorus. Just an option. The phaser would kind of take it in a new direction. But that's the sound. It's very wobbly. And you're going to play low frequencies. So that's the Party Next Door style. Mixed with Drake. So there you have the sound design approach and how to go about it. Thanks for watching today. Again, the new How to Make Drake Beats course is coming out Saturday, 4/23/2016. So we'll give you more information. Just keep in touch and look out for the videos and more information. So thanks for watching. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.